Oh, I mean, how she got around that is unbelievable. But obviously she's qualified. Obviously she's going to pass. The question is, will she get close to 60 votes?
She said the board doesn't know if they're teaching CRT in the classroom, but every other school.
What good is having a board then?
I have so many friends on boards of school districts, and they do know what's being taught. And Ted Cruz brought out, I think it was Ted Cruz, that brought out all these books from that school and said, this is what they're teaching in second grade. This is what they're teaching in third or fifth grade. And it's information I don't want my daughter to learn.
Right.
Yeah, I assume that if you were to compile a list of all the things Ainsley Earhardt is very uncomfortable with her child learning about, that would be an extensive list. And effectively, school would become a little bit of daycare, a little bit of lunch, maybe some rah, 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 America's the best country ever. But bear in mind, they're using this attack that Ketanji Brown Jackson, because she's on the board of this school, is responsible for not only every book that is taught, but for every misinterpretation of that book by every conservative across the country. She's responsible for that too. But it went beyond just what you saw. So let's get into a little bit more of Fox and Friends complaining about the nominee here.
And Cruz said he claimed one of the books accused infants of being racist, and he asked, are babies racist? And she said, I have not reviewed those books, and they had not come up in her work as a judge, which is one of the things she said a lot yesterday, and I have got a feeling she's going to say a lot of it again today. That kicks off today.
A children's book with all these babies. Are babies racist?
Right, no, but everyone knows they are. Everybody knows kids are racist.
So anyway,
it goes without saying. So we'll see the questions asked now. But I just do think it's a joke that people are getting mad at Republicans or Democrats for asking tough questions because she's an African American woman. I think that it would be insulting not to ask tough questions to everyone equally. Just keep it out of 11th grade dating practices and keep it away from beer trips to Red Sox games. And I think people, everything's on the table.
Okay, so there's obviously a lot there that we're going to dive into, including Kilmeade there pulling a Lindsey Graham by making the whole thing over this historic nomination, their grievances about tough questions being asked of some of the most flawed candidates for the Supreme Court in recent history, to Ducey there saying, well, she was asked if this book came up in her legal work, and she said, no, I expect more of that. Because it's true, if you asked her if she's eating puppies and she said no, would you expect that she would also deny eating more baby versions of household pets? Yes, the book for kids did not come up in her legal work. Ask a dumb question, get an answer that you will then use to make yourself look even more dumb. Brett, what are we supposed to do? This is how they're using this time.
Listen, Georgetown Country Day School is a private school. Mm-hmm. How ritzy is it? Ben Mankiewicz went there. So just know, for elitists that don't have any connection to the public school system. And I think that conservative senators and Congress people more than anyone would advocate for putting any weird, insane curriculum into a private school education. And they do on the daily. That is actually their goal, is to replace the entire public school system with for-profit, private, Christian academies for learning that will do exactly all the fundamental things that, when you break it down, even though the specifics are different, and they say critical race theory and they say teaching gender grooming, but in terms of like instilling values and fundamental understandings of things that wouldn't fall into your typical math and science curriculum, they want to put that in all kinds of conservative educational curricula.
Yeah.
And so it's a wild, stupid double standard. And I think that it's pretty obvious to everyone who's not just a Fox News cultist.
Exactly. Yeah. Like the government should like be hands off, except in this particular case where a private school, which they don't want the government to regulate, at a school, a book is available that they're misinterpreting. So the government needs to get in. And at the end of the day, what all of this is about, other than just making themselves look cool to their base, because somehow that works, is encouraging the banning of more books. The banning of books, by the way, there was at least one or two books on that list that are theoretically available at the schools that Ted Cruz sends his kids to. Did that not aggrieve him? He's totally fine with them going there. You know why? Because it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter at all. He's using it as a prop. He doesn't actually care. And I want to highlight Ted Cruz here. But first, I want to acknowledge, because Ainsley Earhardt was shocked there that someone on the board of a school doesn't necessarily know the specific line by line content of every book that might theoretically be available to children. boards of trustees in independent schools, turns out, are different than in school, public school districts. I don't even think they know this stuff in public school districts. But trustees at private schools almost entirely focus on governance and direction, like a 5-year strategic plan, and leave operational issues like curriculum to the heads of schools and their staff. But again, you'd want to know that if you cared at all about the thing that you're talking about. If it is instead a convenient ruse to fill a bit of time and to cause your base to despise this woman that's very well liked, by the way, then you don't care so much about that. You will call these sorts of BS diversions tough questions, as Kilmeade says there. They're not tough. They're nonsensical. They're insane. There's a lot of baked in subtle racism there. That doesn't make them tough, though. But Ted Cruz will evoke a Simonson of Simonson Science thing if we bring up this picture. He had a number of displays like this, full blown up pages from books for kids, because the like kids being introduced to the concept that racial bias exists is unacceptable if you are a very, very dumb person that is fine with racial bias. Brett, thoughts?
I love any time that there is a large sign over the shoulder of someone in Congress, because I then imagine them going into Kinko's or FedEx office and just giggling the whole time as they're waiting for the order to come in. Like, this is gonna get them. Ted Cruz is grandstanding. It is only grandstanding. It only ever will be grandstanding. And anyone who says otherwise doesn't understand that those giant foam core printouts are literally on grand stands behind them.
That's a great point, and I've never actually thought about that. But no, they appreciate a good prop. AOC pointed out another one of the props that Ted Cruz uses, tweeting, "When you're showing off the next book you want banned with the perfect edges and everything to underscore to everyone you haven't actually read it." And I will ask everyone in the audience, how many, I'm not gonna say chapters, I'm not gonna say pages. How many words of The End of Policing has Ted Cruz read? Do each you believe he read a word? I don't believe he read a word.
Oh no, and each situation's ridiculous, because either he didn't read a word, which is very obviously the case, he saw it in some tweet, or he read every single word, and in which case, what a huge waste of time. Mm-hmm. He's poring over these things. No, he's not gonna read through it all the way and have like this thoughtful back and forth. All they ever do. I've talked to multiple people who are saying, I can't believe they're grooming kids in schools with critical race theory, teaching kids that it's evil to be white. That's not the situation. The whole point of school is to teach people, yeah, things to know, but also how to think. And I don't mean what to think, I mean how to think. How to encounter a much debated issue and find out what side of it you come down on, and also being able to argue both sides, understand both sides, and then also take criticism and understand with that same mental muscle how to frame these discussions in the first place. And we can have honest discussions about what should be in high school, elementary school, preschool curriculum. But I don't think any of the people who are making headlines for the subject itself want to have a serious conversation. Yeah. They just want to signal cultural issues to a base rather than deliver tangible legislative results that will help them in the real world and in real life and in real kitchen table issues, not water cooler ones.
That is all very well said and very reasonable, and thus it has no part in any of this. Just doesn't.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.